This is the first cake that I've ever made. The recipe had 418 steps. And I really hope it tastes good, because man, it took a long time to make.
Hi, I'm Curtis Bowdy, and this is The Scope of Science, and I have to be quiet, because I'm in a library. Genes are the recipes that make life, and we have a lot of them. If you wanted to print out all of the genetic information in an individual on paper, like this, to do that, you would have to fill a lot of filing cabinets. You'd have to fill 67 cabinets. That's like all of these cabinets, because we have a lot of information in us. We have around 20,000 genes that make proteins in our bodies. And to make that a little more palatable, I want you to pretend that instead of genes that make proteins, we're talking about recipes that make cakes. I'll explain. Just like genes, recipes evolve. The good ones get passed on. If I make a cake and it tastes good and I give the recipe to my friend, and if they like the recipe, they might pass it on to their friends. And maybe somewhere along the line, someone modifies it and puts in more sugar, and that recipe gets passed on even more. They change and they evolve over time. But if I made a recipe that tasted like socks and I passed that on to my friend, well, I'd be mean. And also my friend probably wouldn't pass it on. So just as recipes, if you have genes that make you more successful and more likely to have offspring, those genes are more likely to get passed on. My mom passed recipes on to me, and she also passed her genes on to me. Roughly half of my DNA comes from my mom and from my dad. And I say roughly half because I share more DNA in common with my mom than with my dad. It isn't a perfectly even split, and a lot of things get garbled up when they get passed on. It's a messy process, but it's that messiness that makes me different than anyone else. It makes my recipes different than anyone else's. But those differences are really small. Even though it takes a whole 67 cabinets to write out my entire genome, it only takes about this much, 210 pages double-sided, to print out the things that make me genetically unique. If these are all recipes, then this is my special spice.
Okay, so maybe by now you get the basic idea of inheritance, but genetics still seems very complicated. So in order to make it as simple as a piece of cake, I'm going to make a piece of cake with a recipe that is 418 steps. If you've ever looked for cake recipes online, you probably had to sift through a bunch of other stuff. There's ads, a review, comments, notes, and buried in there somewhere is the actual recipe. Our genes are a lot like that. Most of them are actually junk, and just a fraction are important instructions. But our cake recipe doesn't look like that. It looks like this. The first thing you'll probably notice about this recipe is that it's only written with four letters, A, U, C, and G. I wrote it that way because our genetic code is also made of just four letters. So here's how I fit 20 different ingredients and 20 different measurements into those four letters. To make this cake, you read the recipe three letters at a time. Those three letters match up with an instruction of what to do.
The very first step in this recipe is AUG. That tells me that I'm going to mix each of the following ingredients, one scoop from each. So I'm going to cross off AUG. The second step in my recipe is ACA. So that means I'm going to take one scoop of soy milk. This is gonna take a while.
The third is CUA, that's all-purpose flour. The fourth is CCG, whole wheat flour, one scoop. AGA is white sugar. UUU, that's red wine vinegar. UUA, that's all-purpose flour, again. Brown sugar, flour, white sugar, water, almond milk, and so on. Some of the ingredients have one code on them, like almond extract is CAU, whereas some of them have multiple codes on them, like vanilla extract can be GAA or GAG. But what's important is that yes, there's redundancy, but if I see the letters GAA, that could only be vanilla extract. And same with GAG. It will only be vanilla extract. It doesn't relate to anything else. As you can probably imagine, it took me a long time to do all 418 steps. But what's crazy is that that process is actually taking place in every single one of your cells right now, except that instead of making cakes, they're making proteins, because remember, the cake is a lie. And your cells are actually going through those steps way faster than I can do. They read about 20 steps every single second. So they would go through this 418 step recipe in 21 seconds. Now to compare, it took me 2 hours, and that's not including baking the cake. So that's 340 times faster than I can do.
I'm so looking forward to not scooping any more of the flour. Oh look, more flour. It's UUA. Oh my god. Oh man, we did it! We did it!
Eventually I get to UAA, and that tells me that I can finally stop mixing the ingredients together and I can bake the cake. Bake the cake!
Good luck, little buddy.
It looks like cake, it looks like cake! Huh. It's good cake? I did it! Oh, it's actually really good. It's moist, but like in a good way. We go from a pile of goop to a cake. This is cake. It's different than before because it has emergent properties. There's things like baking soda and vinegar and lemon juice, and those interact to change it so that it's no longer a pile of goop, but it's pretty tasty cake. Proteins also have emergent properties, and that's why we aren't just a pile of goop. But we're a good cake, metaphorically. If you like this video, give it the thumbs up, and also go and check out the video I made on how the eye evolved. I demonstrate it by building a digital camera, and I think if you're into this kind of thing, then you'll be into that, so please check it out. And I'm making big metaphor videos once a month on this channel, The Scope of Science, so you can subscribe for that, and you can click on the bell to get notified whenever I put out a new video. I only put out a video about once a month, but I put the whole month into making that video as awesome as I can, so if you don't want to miss those, please just click the bell and it'll notify you. And thanks so much for watching.